Indianapolis made the catch for them, and he is up across the 25 to near the 27-28. So he's a little bit short of the first down.
Keith, this is a wide open, fun offense. It's basketball on grass. Football's flying all over the place. Again, it's critical today, the time of possession, to move the chains, get first downs. This is a great scramble by Breeze, and all of a sudden he locates his man who's wide open. They've got a shot at the first here. Don't make it. Good close by Washington, and they'll be running to the football aggressively this afternoon.
But it gives you an idea of what the Husky secondary and are looking at for the rest of the afternoon. Breeze again rolls out. Again, it's light protecting, and they force him wide. He's looking, nothing there. He tries to run the ball, and he stepped out of bounds just short of the 25-yard line as the Huskies put him on his back, and the Boilermakers are going to have to put the ball in the air with the foot.
It's a great lick by Anthony Kelly, who's starting in front of Williams at that outside linebacker spot. He had a shot at Breeze. He took it, put him on his back. He's going to say, hey, we're going to be coming after you all day. We want Breeze to have his head on a swivel and looking for us.
In the punt now is Scott Kurz. K-U-R-Z is his name. Toure Butler is waiting for the Huskies, standing back inside his 40 at about the 42.
Washington's going to have good field position.
Snap was high. The kick is away, and it's a good one. It's a high-hanging spiral that is caught by Butler, and he is put away quickly, but too quickly, by Vinny Sutherland. There'll be a flag on it, and it'll cost the Purdue 5 yards.
Jumped into the halo. He's got to stay outside the 2-yard circle, and all of a sudden, he was in there, didn't give him enough room. That'll cost him. You know, it's still, this serves a purpose. Washington will have great field position, but again, you get a great lick like that early, and it really gets their attention. Listen to it. That's football, smash mouth football.
Well, it was also perhaps not a very good decision by Butler, because he could have lost the ball in that circumstance, because they were looking right down the barrel at him, and he certainly should have been able to see him and call a fair catch.
But you know, that's the purpose of that 2-yard halo. Even if he catches that ball, they're still supposed to give him room to make the catch and avoid the injury.
All right, here come the Huskies for their first snap. The ball is just beyond the 35-yard line. Tuiasosefo is collared a yard short of the line of scrimmage. At quarterback, you've got an old-fashioned kind of football player in the AT&T starting lineup for the Washington Huskies. You just show him the place and tell him the time, and he'll come wearing whatever you want. Marcus Tuiasosefo. He's a tough guy. He wills this team up and down the field.
And unlike Breeze, where they use the pass to set up the run, Washington will use the legs of Tuiasosefo. They'll use the run to set up his pass.
Second down, 11. Neither one of the quarterbacks getting a very dramatic start in this ball game. Tuiasosefo rolling out, pursuit coming, passes way to the sideline. It's caught, but didn't amount to much. Over on the sideline. So the backs and receivers now for the Huskies. They're beat up at these positions. Braxton Clemens starting at tailback. Rich Alexis and Willa Hurst will play with sore shoulders. Justin Robbins has a sore shoulder. Todd Elstrom a sore leg. The tight end, Jerry Stevens, is healthy. The offensive front, they're 5 300-pounders here, and they, I expect today, will try to pound away as the game wears on.
In third and long situations, Keith, with Washington, look for the tight end, Jeremy Stevens. He's 6'7". He's got an advantage in height, and Tuiasosefo has to put the ball high.
On third and 9, pressure. Tuiasosefo breaks the pressure, throws the ball downfield, and the pass is incomplete, but there's a penalty flag, and it's called against Chris Clopton, a 5'7" cornerback trying to defend Justin Robbins, a 6-footer.
They look for Stevens. He was covered. They went deep. He was open for a second, but they now have to decide if that ball was catchable.
They apparently have decided.
Here's the scramble. He's looking right now for Stevens, but he's got a lot of pressure. He scrambles out as he does so well, finds the deep receiver. Was this ball catchable? I don't think so. But they ruled it was, and so they move him down.
It's a 15-yard penalty, remember, in college football, and a first down. The ball is on the Purdue side of the field for the first time today for Washington, in possession at the Boilermaker 48-yard line. Clemens, the tailback, runs into the pile, and and will get down to the 45-yard line. Defensively for the Purdue Boilermakers, it is a quick, athletic group. The tackles Terrell and Mitrione weigh in the 280s, and they are really active people. The linebackers, along with the safeties, make up the heart of the defense. You need to know that there are five freshmen in this defensive unit, but the season's over now. There are no more freshmen. Good size at safeties, but Chris Clapton, I told you, was only 5'7". Coaches say he's a pit bull, but he's still only 5'7".
Yeah, and speed is the biggest asset of this defense.
Second down and 8. Ball thrown to the sidelines. It is Jeremy Stevens, the tight end. Stevens is a 6'7", 255-pound sophomore out of Olympia. He's a very agile tight end, very quick for a guy that size.
He's a problem maker for the Boilermakers, and they know it. They're preparing, knowing that Stevens is going to have a big part in this game plan. Not only is he tall, he can run, and after he catches it, he can elude a lot of tacklers. That's good coverage and a good tackle, but he's going to cause some problems later.
Number 14, different number for a tight end. Nobody behind Tua Yasosopo now as Conniff comes out in motion. He can catch the ball, too. Tua goes to the outside now. There are two men after him. Now he throws and ends completed down the field to Pat Reddick, the junior out of Newberry Park, California, at the 20-yard line. So that's the agility of Tua Yasosopo that makes you commit. And then all of a sudden, bang, he's got a target.
You know, we've seen him so often, Keith. He's not the best passer in the conference. He's not the best runner, but definitely the most dangerous. They cannot keep him in the pocket. He feels the pressure again. It's almost instinctive. He rolls, and once he rolls, now they've got to be concerned with the run. When they come up, then you find your receiver. There he is, Reddick. He's got the first down. They move the chains. This offense scored 30 points 8 times this year.
It is first down from the 20-yard line on the Purdue side of the field for the Washington Huskies. Option play. It's the veer left, and Tua Yasosopo will go down to the 15-yard line. The first play of the ball game was called today by Pelpack. May you memory live forever. Handed over the left side to Pat Conniff, the fullback. Bangs in there, got a yard, maybe a yard and a half. And now across the field, you've got a flag.
Take a look at the Dell game solutions for Washington. We mentioned time of possession is critical. They want to keep Brees off the field, so they want to shorten the game, melt the clock, move the chains, and they're doing that right now. Tua Yasosopo has to spread the wealth. He's doing that. He can't do it all himself. He has to get Stevens involved. He has to get Clement as running back and Alexis in the game. He's got to get everybody involved in their game plan.
That's an offside penalty.
By the defense, 5-yard penalty. That's a first down.
So that's it's a big mistake by the Boilermakers because it gives Washington a first down. It's going to put the football right on the 10-yard line, first and goal.
Keep in mind, Purdue has not been in the Rose Bowl since the 1960s. Right now, their hearts are pounding through their chest. They've got cotton mouth right now. They've got to adjust.
Last time they were here, Timmy, candy bars were a nickel, and Frank was singing Strangers in the Night.
The point is right now, they've got to settle down. They've got to take this first blow by Washington and settle down and get in their game plan and not panic.
Now let's see what this great big old offensive front can do for the Huskies. Conniff is the man moving. Tua Yasosopo looking to throw. Passes away underneath to Stevens, the tight end. And Stevens battles his way to the goal line. The ball comes out, and they're going to say what?
He was down inside the one. His knee hit.
Well, an extra effort there, trying to fight his way into the end zone, almost cost him the football. There was a freshman safety, Stuart Schweikert, that laid a lick on him and almost took the ball away.
Keith, I've made the point twice, and I will throughout the day. This guy is the biggest threat outside of Tua Yasosopo, and they're going to use him all day long. He's a great receiver. He gets upfield. He's a tight end who can run. He's 6'7". He got all the way down to the one. I'd just run Tua Yasosopo on the quarterback sneak here and get the 6 on the board.
Willie Hurst is in the game, but he's cold. I would imagine Tua takes this one. Oh, he gave it away to Conniff, the fullback.
There's a flag.
And there's a flag. I don't know why you have to hand the ball off. They needed 4 inches.
I agree with you, but you know, that's a great story. That's Tua Yasosopo giving it off to his boyhood friend, Pat Conniff. He wants to share the wealth.
They're calling the flag against Purdue, looks like. At least the Huskies are begging the case there.
Well, you can't get any closer to the goal line.
Gained 2 inches on the penalty.
Oh, what a great story he is. All those years, one winning season.
Offside, defense, half the distance to the goal. Repeat, second down.
He comes in and takes him to 4 straight bowls. Keith, that's already the fourth penalty against Purdue. That's nerves.
They know they've got to be aggressive and attack, though, because they're outsized.
Yeah, but emotion gets in the way of concentration.
Curry keeps it this time, pitches it outside, and touchdown. Braxton Clemen walked in. Well, it may not have been pretty, and it may not have been fancy, but it counts.
His timing is impeccable. He knows they're looking for him on the corner. He reads so well. His decision-making is so solid. He read that defensive end came to him. He pitched it to the pitch man who was wide open and just walked in.
Used about 4.5 minutes on that possession, too. Eight plays, 64 yards. Five, actually 5'11" on that possession. John Anderson out of Boynton Beach, Florida, will try the point out of Cody Pickett's hole. It's up. It's good. And so the Washington Huskies strike here in the first quarter and stick it in the end zone in their first possession.
To me, he needs to settle down. On the other hand, you mentioned Washington wasn't pretty, and yet Tui Asisopo 4 for 4, 36 yards on that drive.
Here's the strength of Anderson's leg back into the end zone, 6-7 yards deep, and it'll come out to the 20. Here's the Husky defense now. Number 70, nose tackle Larry Triplett, is Purdue's biggest worry. He is a disruptor. He'll probably be double teamed most of the day, and that opens opportunities for others. The linebackers play like defensive ends. Farms and Kelly are like arrows off the perimeter. Front seven are the key for the Huskies' defense. Secondary, well, any secondary against Drew Brees is going to have a long afternoon. These people can play, though. True freshman Carruthers replaced Curtis Williams at that free safety position.
You mentioned Larry Triplett. He is an outstanding player. He's going to try to line up as much as he can on Ian Allen. He thinks he can beat Allen, and so they'll slide him over that side of the center, like right now. See him moving?
Yeah, he moved about a yard. With Montrell Lowe from LaPorte, Texas, and Montrell Fman from Monrovia, Indiana. Here's a look at our Tostitos team comparison.
Pretty interesting team comparison, too. If you look by sacks, Washington's had 33 of them, and that's with Tui Asisopo being as mobile as he is. But here's what we were just talking about. Brees has been sacked only 7 times this year. All the Purdue quarterbacks only 8 times all year. To me, that is incredible.
The football has been moved just short of the 35, where it's a first down for the Boilermakers. The backup quarterback today, incidentally, is David Edgerton, a senior from Garden City, Kansas Community College. Brees working out of the shotgun. Very quick release. Fires his tight end. He's voted the top tight end in the country and got the Mackey Award. Tim Stratton, a junior from Oak Brook, Illinois, and another first down.
We talked a lot about Stevens on the other side being 6'7". Stratton, as you mentioned, the John Mackey Award winner.
Here's the penalty, Tim.
Offsides by the defense. That penalty is refused. First down.
But the point I was going to make is Stratton also.
Pressure set. Well, that's 8. So the Huskies penetrate. Darryl Daniels, inside linebacker. You get involved and start double-teaming Triplett now, that's going to open the door for Daniels and Madavi, and Daniels came walking right through it.
Well, just as we tell you that he's only been sacked 7 times all year, here they come, and they bring it right up the middle. They try to overload. Look at this. They run a little quick stunt. Here comes Daniels, 24, finds the open area and makes the sack. They call him Double D, as you mentioned, but here's the deal. Rick Neuheisel calls him the piano guy, says he runs like he's got a piano on his back. He's not fast, but he's smart, and he's aggressive.
Second down and 16 now for Purdue. Working out of the shotgun, Brees hands the ball off. Penalty flag was thrown. The play goes to the right side with low carrying. And he might have teased the Huskies into the neutral zone. Yeah, he did. Let me give the officials. They're from the Atlantic Coast Conference. Jack Childress, we told you, the referee. Rosario Amato, the umpire. Bud Elliott, the head linesman. Ted Jackson, the line judge. Daryl Harrison, the side judge. John Armstrong, the field judge. Virgil Valdez, the back judge. And Ron Cherry is your alternate. So from one coast to the other, or Purdue. Gives the ball back to Lowe, and the Huskies eat him up. right on the 45-yard line. Oregon State is a full bore, wide open, let her rip football team. Drew Brees with time, looking around, going big. He's got a man in the corner. It's incomplete, overthrew him. Seth Morales, a sophomore from Indianapolis, running under the ball.
Tell you what's pretty interesting, that Washington that time went to a zone blitz and got everybody back and had two guys that were playing free in the back of that zone. 14, 15 guys in the huddle. They're substituting from the field. You'll see when they run it, you'll see 41 drop out of there. He was up at the line of scrimmage. They're in that zone blitz. He throws it out of bounds. Good defense.
The receiver's confused running out of bounds anyway. He disqualified himself by running out of bounds for about 12 yards.
That's correct.
High snap over the head of the punter. Goes back and covers the ball at the 25-yard line. Tim Stratton snapped it. The ball went sailing over the punter's head. Travis Dortch is the place kicker, and the punter is Scott Kurtz. And Kurtz, that chance, couldn't handle it. It was just too high. If it had been Dortch, the place kicker, he's 6'6". He'd have made the catch. So Purdue makes another mistake.
Got to settle down.
Well, they put the Washington Huskies in position to make their mountain a little higher, I'll tell you, because at the 25-yard line, first down, and Drew Brees on the sidelines and on the phone.
Here's the big guy, Stevens.
He drops straight back. Eats coming. Gets it away. And it is incomplete. He threw it away. Once you get outside the tackle in college football, you can throw the ball in the seats if you want to.
You know, that's a good point. You look at both of these guys, Keith, and you and I talked about this at great length this whole week. Brees and Tui Asisopo are probably two of the most cerebral quarterbacks you'll ever find. They study the game, they're students of the game, they know the rules, and they utilize the rules. That's certainly one they both know. They will not take sacks if they can help it.
Second down and 10 from the Boilermaker 25-yard line. Nobody behind him. The middle he goes. He's a big guy down to the 5-yard line, first and goal. He puts Stuart Swigert, the safety, on his back, and he's got a first and goal at the 5.
Every guy on that offensive line outweighs the Purdue defensive line by 40 pounds. Now watch the push off this line of scrimmage as soon as the ball is snapped. There's the trap. There's the play. It's a counter, actually. He cuts out behind the guard and makes a great play out of it. It's a very nice job up front by the 300-pound Frays and the 335-pound Ward to open that hole.
Tuiasosopo keeps it. He's warming up. That's his shoe that he's carrying as he goes to the bench looking for some shade. Now here's John Anderson trying to make it 14 to nothing. And 42 seconds remaining in the first quarter of the Rose Bowl game in Pasadena. John Anderson kicking off now for the Washington Huskies. Purdue has Vinny Sutherland and Chris Clupton as the deep people, 14 and 23 respectively. That's Clupton right there. And here's Mr. Anderson. He's going to drop this one a yard short of the end zone to Clupton. Burner. Penalty flag. Clapton tackled at about the 35-36-yard line, but the flag was thrown back around the 20. And I do believe it came from the referee, Mr. Jukes. Purdue's one mistake after another so far. That's a holding call against the Boilermakers.
Keith, let's take another look at the touchdown, because Washington is breaking tendencies. Down tight like this, goal line.
Over a while ago, and it cost him dearly with that high snap. gave the Huskies the opportunity, and they took advantage of it. This is Montrell Lowe trying to find some room, and he comes out to about the 15-yard line.
Keith, take a look at the Dell Game Solutions for Purdue. They, too, want to move the chains and melt the clock and keep it away from Tuiasosopo, but they've run 12 plays, and five of those have been for negative yardage. Keep Triplett off Breeze. They're going to try to double-team him. We've already seen Triplett moving over to get over Allen because he thinks he can be...
He's run at what I guess you'd call four levels. Isn't that what the phraseology they put on it? Ball is pitched back to low. They're looking to run the ball a little bit, and they can run the ball. I told you that this offensive line is not just a bunch of pass blockers. They'll get out there and swap paint with you. And they did it just there as they put the ball up to the 30-yard line.
And they set up the run with the pass. Breeze came out firing today, not very effectively, but now they've loosened it up. They've taken some of the defenders out of the box, and so now they're going to let Lowe do it. He's a hard guy to get a hold of because he's only 5'7 and a half. He ran for 200 yards against Indiana. He's got tremendous speed, low center of gravity, very tough to tackle.
They pulled their big old Brandon Doran back there, 304-pound tackle. And he got out in front as the lead blocker. Opened the door for him. Here comes Lowe again. And he's got good yardage on that play. Picked up about eight on that carry. Hakeem Akbar making the tackle. Today's aerial coverage being provided by AT&T at the Rose Bowl.
You know, when you have a little guy like Lowe, Keith, I call him a hide-and-seek runner because he hides behind those big guys on that offensive line and seeks his hole before the defenders can locate him. He's so short, they can't find him.
A.T. Simpson comes into the ball game. He's caught one ball today, second down and long two. Oh, it's his series. And he's hit right at the marker by Akbar. Akbar just nailed him, and he's got a penalty flag.
And it's going to be holding against Purdue again, so the Boilermakers will hurt themselves once they had second and short. Every time they get in a decent situation, they hurt themselves.
Akbar, Hakeem was the...
And Purdue's going to be in it, really in it, by the fourth quarter.
Well, they almost got him. Now that's the second time they've sacked him. Anthony Kelly.
We showed you that earlier. They've got two already in the first quarter.
That's 473 snaps. Incredible. Pressure's still coming, and he gets it away. This time down the middle, the pass is caught. John Stendiford. Greg Carruthers made the tackle, and there's the quality of Drew Brees right there. That would be the fourth level, I believe, of their offense. He looked one, he looked two, he looked three, and then hit four.
Take a look at this. This is a freshman who's going to do this. You've got two receivers out here. He's reading them both, but he's looking right now for the post. He sees they're in a two deep, five under zone. Now they let him go. See that? They release him into the open area, and that's where Drew Brees finds him before he gets to the safety. Well thrown, well educated.
First down, 46-yard line, 30-yard pickup on the play. Ball is handed off to Lowe again, and Montrell Lowe will go for 4 yards on the carry. ABC Sports is the home of the Bowl Championship Series on Wednesday night. And will soon be going out onto the field. It's going to start cooling off. Ball is handed off again to Montrell Lowe. And Lowe, who's having a pretty good day, will go down to about the 43-yard line.
Purdue's offensive line now starting to pound. If they can get that big offensive line going, Purdue will jump back in this game in a hurry.
Time running out on the first quarter of play. The final 4 seconds ticking away. And at the end of one, it's 14-0 Washington. ABC Sports coverage of the Rose Bowl presented by AT&T returns after this message and the word from our ABC station. Flashes over the left side, picks up the first down for the Purdue Boilermakers, and they'll put the ball at the Washington 33-yard line.
You know, coming into this game, every time Drew Brees would scramble in his last six outings, he got 4 yards or more. They're containing him pretty well here, so it's a good change to go to low. Now, look at this huddle by Washington. They are substituting on the field to the sidelines and not from the sidelines to the field. This time, they only had 11 guys, but they've been putting 14, 15 guys in there and then running them off the field.
They'll change that rule, I bet you. On first down, the Boilermakers, Brees back, pumps once, looks left, goes right, ball's in the air, and out of bounds, incomplete. And a penalty flag. The flag is thrown.
Comparison, and obviously, Tui Asisopo has a brilliant first quarter and just got two scores on the board. Brees still trying to find his way a little bit. If you look at what he's doing, completion and attempts, it looks pretty good, but he's been knocked down four times, and you see the rush yards, Brees, 84 of them.
Well, that got Rick's attention. Ball's about 4 feet over his head. There's the pitch back to low. He's having a big one. That's his 10th carry. Ball comes out.
It was out of bounds before Washington recovered it. As a matter of fact, I think that Purdue's going to pick up an extra yard by the flip by of the ball.
Akbar is the man who hit him. Ball is fumbled forward, out of bounds. Daniels covered it, but he was out of bounds. That's 10 carries now for Lowe, and he's over 50 yards.
Here's the ruling, and they're exactly right. You cannot fumble this ball forward and gain yardage, and you'll see as soon as it comes out of his hand, boom. All right, now right there where he's down is where that ball is going to be marked. Spot of the fumble. Where that ball came out of his hands, spot of the fumble is where that ball is marked now.
13-yard line, and second down and five. Hands the ball to Lowe, and Lowe gets hit by Larry Triplett. And Triplett doesn't wrap him and hold him down, but he's going to lose a yard or so on the play because Larry Triplett is a big, strong man. So third down and six. They go back to the shotgun. Reese throws underneath. Ball is caught by Standiford. And Standiford will get taken out of bounds at about the six-yard line.
But he'll pick up the first down, Keith, so it'll be first and goal now for Purdue. They're starting to move. They're more in rhythm, more in sync, getting more confidence. Standiford, just a true freshman. How about this? He's a terrific basketball player, but this time last, this is fun.
He got that big old tackle now as a lead blocker. Number 77 did a good job, too. He took his man down. Brandon Gorin decked one of the Huskies and opened the way for the running back low. You know, Purdue backed up 5 yards on the penalty.
Here's the problem, though, Keith. With that hit, Akbar goes out now, and he's shaking up a little bit.
That's an illegal formation, and that came up in conversation between Rick Neuheisel and the referees before. Into Biddle, who had just come into the ball game, the sophomore out of Bellevue, and Biddle makes the tackle.
Montrell Lowe has to be careful with the football. We saw him lose it once. That time he was carrying it very dangerously low. He's got to tuck that thing away, put his fingers around the end of the ball, put it up against his body, and hold on to it. Now watch when he spins. Watch this ball way down here right now, and almost did lose it.
Yeah, he did. Well, he's got it again. Is out there, almost taken away again, but he got away with it. And they've stopped him just short of the 5-yard line.
So it'll bring up third and goal, Keith. They've got to get out and use the width of the field here. They've got to get on the corner, give Drew Brees the option of passing or running, and stretch the defense a little bit.
Well, they send some wideouts onto the field now.
I'd go with the big guy, Tim Stratton, but they at least have to get on the corner and use the width of the field.
Where Stratton is. Well, he's lined up on the right side. He's flexed out about 3 yards.
15th play of this drive.
Coming back to the line of scrimmage now. Stratton hookers down right alongside of Gorin. He's not going out. He's blocking. The ball thrown to the end zone. Touchdown, Vinny Sutherland.
Boy, give Jim Chaney, the offensive coordinator, and Joe Tiller a lot of credit. things were getting tight in there. They kept running low. Washington closed down on them, so they come out, they spread the field sideline to sideline, create space. They created air so they could get a pass in, and Sutherland found the open crease.
The extra point try now from Travis Dorsch, who I believe is the tallest place kicker in the country at 6'6". And the kick is good. And the Boilermakers on the board. As we get started here in the second quarter of play, it's now 14-7 as they go 90 yards and 15 plays.
It's the last time they were here, huh? Mascot was a party drink.
They've had a good time out here. Rui Asisoko, a little drop off here. Pass to Willie Hurst. Willie Hurst just gets smothered, and the Boilers pick up the ball and run away with it, but it's going to be called down. It's Gilbert Gardner, who is a freshman from Angleton, Texas, who made the tackle.
He came to Purdue as a receiver, never played linebacker before this year. Actually was recruited as a wide receiver, but look what he does here. He comes up fast, closes inside out, doesn't give him anywhere to go, and makes a good, solid tackle.
And he's happy about it.
Well, and you can see and feel the momentum of the game changing a little bit as Purdue now has settled down, and now they're starting to play football.
And it's second down for the Huskies, and ball's back around the 14-yard line. Ball is thrown off the hands. That's the kind of a ball that is picked off. It was thrown for Todd Elstrom, and Elstrom could not get up and pull it down. Thrown hard and high, and turned into a tip. And you hold your breath on those.
Sure do. My daddy used to say, if it hits your hands, you better catch it. And I know that prior to the game, Rick Neuheisel was upset with all of his receivers because they weren't catching the ball. Woodyard had given him space to make the catch. It was high and hard. They got to go up and get those.
It's third down and officially a 15, though it's a little more than that. Crowd in that end zone. Those are mostly Purdue folks, and they're trying to help their team. And Tui Asisoko back gets the pass away down the middle. It is to the tight end, Jeremy Stevens, and it's a first down up at the 36-yard line. Oh, he is a big target and a prime weapon. 21-yard pickup.
Anytime they flex you out like that and they spread the field, the inside receiver is the most dangerous. We told you about Stevens and his height. Now, here he is in here, and he's just going to come down the middle of that Purdue defense. He's got the most field to work with. Here he comes down the middle, actually circled the wrong guy, but he was the inside guy of the three receivers flexed from his tight end spot and found that middle seam.
He left the ball game right after that catch, and he was dragging a leg a little bit, but he was by himself. And here's a penalty flag. The ball is handed off to Willie Hurst. Flag is thrown to the linesman across the way, and Willie's out just over the 40 to the 41.
Can I circle the wrong guy? He's 6'7". Can't miss him. I'm the only guy in the stadium that missed him.
Offsides, Purdue.
I got so excited because I knew he was going to be the guy.
You've been out here in Pasadena too long. I'll send you back there where it's cold and the weather's, life is harsh.
I got to get you back there with me.
By the defense, 5 yard previous spot. Repeat first down.
That is the eighth penalty, Tim, on Purdue. The 56 yards. That's hurting yourself.
It really is. And again, we said earlier, emotion gets in the way of concentration. They've got to be smarter. You don't mind aggressive, over-aggressive penalties occasionally. But when you're just making stupid mistakes, coaches will just go crazy.
First and five for the Huskies. All handed to Hurst. Well, they jump all over, Willie. Let's spend a moment with Todd Harris on the field.
Well, Keith, Jeremy Stevens is coming back in. It looked like he had a helmet to the thigh, pointed to the train. They just did a quick massage on it. One other note, Aiken Adell on the Purdue side is yelling at his defensive players to watch the eyes of Marcus Tui Asisoko. He thinks if you watch Marcus's eyes, he will give away which way he's going to run on a run. But we've seen that all year, and the Pac-10, not many people have been successful in doing that. Keith?
What's the temperature down there now, Todd? It's cooled off?
Yeah, it's balmy 82. I think at game time it was closer to 90, but the folks in Purdue now enjoying the weather more typical to what they have. I know in West Lafayette it's 20 degrees right now.
Yeah, it was a high of 21 today. 50 in Seattle today. Here's Tui Asisoko pitching it wide. It won't work, folks. They were looking for it, and they found it. Landon Johnson was in the right place at the right time. He's another Texan.
Aiken Adell might be on to something if Marcus is tipping things off. Adell is a smart player, 19 sacks in 2 years, so he knows how to read a quarterback's eyes.
So they have squandered that first and five circumstance as they go back to third down and 10.
Purdue is undersized up front. Substitutions are key. They've got to rotate them in that heat that you just talked about with Todd. But at the same time, they've got to use that quickness that they have, that advantage in quickness, to their advantage.
Well, Hurst catches, but it's well short of the first down marker. He's taken down at about the 42-yard line. Landon Johnson again in on the play. Another fresh. Sutherland calls fair catch at the 19-yard line. And there Purdue will have it. First down, a 14-7 ball game. And right now it appears that Mo might be wearing white. This is Montrell Lowe. And he spins away for 4 yards. Fiesta Bowl, Tostitos Fiesta Bowl tonight over in Tempe. Next on ABC, home of the Bowl Championship Series, it's Oregon State and Notre Dame. Second down and 6. Huskies almost got in that neutral zone, they may have. Montrell Lowe breaks the play and gets it out across the 30 for the first down. And it may well be it's an offside against Washington. They'll take the play. They're getting serious now.
They are. You know, last year everybody talked about the Pac-10 being the poorest tackling conference and not being aggressive. Well, look at this. Tuck your tail, sky your eyes, drive right through his chin, and it knocked his helmet off. Carruthers is just a young guy, too, a freshman.
Jerry Claiborne teach you that?
Oh, that is a picture-perfect form tackle by Greg Carruthers, the freshman.
Second down and short 6. Huskies are offside. They were in the neutral zone. They got a flag. The guy on this side was penetrated. The flag came from across the way. Cedric Brown gets his first carry of the ball game. He's a 236-pound sophomore from Flower, Texas.
You know, Keith, you're talking about Jerry Claiborne teaching that tackling. Carruthers is a coach's kid. He's fundamentally sound.
Offside, defense, 5 yards, previous spot, first down.
There's a look at Carruthers, the young freshman, 6'2", 190-pounder. This time last year, he was playing high school ball.
Second down, they need a yard. They run for it with the big guy rumbling. And Brown will go down to the 41-yard line for a Purdue first down. So the Boilermakers are moving the chains. There's your Aflac trivia question we asked you a while ago. Who kicked the winning extra point for Purdue in the 1967 Rose Bowl? Well, USC, the opposition, went for two. And George Katavalos intercepted the ball to stop the two-point conversion try. Bob Greasy, the quarterback, kicked the extra point. Now, I want to tell you something as we come back to the field of play and the Huskies handle the running try. You saw Greasy walk up there and smack that thing and head came right up with it. Well, he took that same move right to the first tee.
Let me tell you something. Greasy was playing back when that was film. That stuff would bounce around. I was surprised they had face masks.
Happy New Year, Greasy.
He's a good man.
Ball is on the 47-yard line where it is second down. Still 10, about 10 and a half for Purdue. And they go to the shotgun with double wide. They've actually got three wide receivers up at the top of the screen. And put a fourth in motion. And Breeze getting pressure. Dumps it off underneath. And he short hopped it, didn't he?
That was well defended. You know, you're talking about Bob Greasy. Of course, when Bob was at Purdue, he set a lot of the records. But look how times have changed. Look how the passing game has come into football. I mean, just look at the yards. And, I mean, look at all the school records. And listen to the music. That's your kind of stuff, Keith.
Oh, yeah.
That's taking you back in time. That was Bob Greasy's music. That was the number one song that year, wasn't it?
Winchester Cathedral was a big hit that year, and so was Michelle.
Cathedral.
Third down and 9. Breeze getting some pressure. Passes away. Short hopped that one. And avoided the sack. Rock Alexander, who has been in the ball game playing in the nickel package, and Rock making his presence known.
Just when it looked like Purdue was starting to gain some momentum here, the defense asserted itself. A couple of good hits by Carruthers and Akbar, and Triplett got in the act that time, and they stopped them.
Scott Kurz now, the punter, is into the ball game.
Keith,
Toure Butler is waiting for it.
This is the field position. You have to, if you're on defense, you have to watch for a fake.
Tim Stratton, the tight end, does the snapping. He's trying to hit it up the elevator shaft, and he's got it up there, and a fair catch is called. And now they throw the flag. They have to throw the flag. I mean, it has to. It's automatic, isn't it?
Well, there was contact, sure.
Yes, contact.
Anytime there's contact like that on a fair catch, you've got to throw a flag.
Stratton, the man that snapped the ball.
Non-contact, kick catching interference by the kicking team. Five yards from the spot. First down.
It was contact made.
Hey, Jack.
But you know what? Even if that guy's coming forward, that receiver's coming forward to make that catch, you've got to give him the leeway. You've got to give him all the space to make that catch.
Well, Tim tried to avoid him, and his momentum just carried him right into it. So that's the end of that, too.
Report, four games already in the books today. And Terry, in a couple of days, your dad will pay for the night.
On first down from the 42, the ball is thrown to Vinnie Sutherland on the sidelines, and just that quickly, you're across the 50 and down to the Washington 47 for a first down.
Washington got a big break on the punt. There should have been interference call because Rock Alexander came down and actually touched the receiver, hit the receiver, tried to tackle the receiver after he called fair catch. Now Breeze comes out with two timeouts, great field position. Purdue's in terrific shape here.
Call it the 48-yard line for the first down snap. Staying in the shotgun where he has more time and more vision and throws, and the receiver falls down. Vinnie Sutherland lost his footing and goes down, incomplete forward pass. Short hopped it. It's very hard. When you run across that rose out there in the middle of the field, it's like running across a sheet of ice. You tell your story.
Well,
it's
here's the deal.
Story.
Here's the deal. You know, they had helicopters out here today trying to dry the paint on this field because the weather's been so good, the grass is growing through the paint, and had to repaint it. Bad part is, I sat here for 20 minutes today watching the paint dry.
We got to get you, buy you some books or something. Ball is thrown short underneath, completed to A.T. Simpson, and Simpson is wrestled down at about the 43-yard line. At least some crayons.
They had to keep repainting the field because they had to cut it because the grass was growing.
That's funny.
That helicopter driver was good, though. He was going up and down this football field.
We haven't had any rain around here in 3 months. Here it comes. Bang, that slant. Seth Morales got position in front of Von Tour and ate him up. And it's first down Purdue at the Washington 27-yard line. You cannot defend that play if you give that man that position.
Well, and they're protecting Breeze better. And Breeze is throwing on time. He's delivering on schedule. And you're right. Anytime you've got a good receiver out there that uses his body for positioning, they're going to complete it.
Breeze pass goes down the pipe. Incomplete and almost intercepted. Intended for John Standiford, and Rock Alexander had a chance to come away with that one.
Told you that this is a wide-open, fun offense. Tiller calls it basketball on grass, and they've got footballs flying all over the place. He loves this offense. It's fun for the kids. Boy, this one's almost picked off, though. Should have been a touchdown number one. Standiford lets it go right through his hands, but look at Alexander still fighting the ball and really had a chance to intercept it. He had to locate it and hit him up on the shoulder pad, and he couldn't get his arms up.
Second down and 10 from the 27. 53 seconds to play in the first half. 14-7 ball game. Drew Brees throwing for the end zone. And it's incomplete. Too high, too deep for Vinnie Sutherland. He was defended by Chris Messi. Vinnie Sutherland is a 5'10", 194-pound senior.
He's listed as 5'10", but I'll guarantee you he's not any more than 5'8 and a half, 5'9. I mean that. He's more like a Wayne Corbett type wide receiver.
Incidentally, you see two or three of the players, including Sutherland, wearing the pad with the plays on their wrist. I'm told that Drew Brees wears that armband with 100 plays.
Yeah, all number. Good number. He knows what the number is. They call number five. He knows it.
Third down and 10. A little play action. And throws to the sidelines to Sutherland for the first down. How good is that kind of stuff, huh? They had him spread out. Washington 13. To the sidelines again he goes. And it is caught and taken out of bounds, stopping the clock at 37 seconds. And it was Chris James making that reception. Boilermakers have it at the 9-yard line of Washington, second down. Reese pumps, throws, no. Intended for Sutherland.
Yeah, and that wasn't a good
third down from the 9. Third and 6. He's pointing to the left side.
And a defensive man free. They had to cover him. And here he comes.
And the pass to the end zone is incomplete. Good coverage for the Huskies that time. Pass intended for A.T. Simpson, Omari Lowe. And it is a 26-yard try. Chip shot for Travis. It's good. So we've got 26 seconds remaining in this first half, and Purdue adds three more to make it a 14-10 ball game. Here's the scoring summary in the ball game. Washington out to a 14-0 lead, but then Purdue has now come back with a touchdown and a 26-yard field goal by Dortch to make it 14-10 and 26 seconds remaining in the half.
Yeah, but that field goal, Washington dodged a bullet. Standiford dropped a touchdown pass, and Breeze overthrew another one.
Derek Johnson is the single man for Washington. Huskies are looking for a return here. Sopo on the sidelines waiting for one more shot at it. This is a good high deep kick by Dortch. He'd be better off to leave it in the end zone. He's coming out. He's got a wedge. And he goes down at the 17-yard line. Moon, two rushing touchdowns, another passing, and he was named the game's MVP. After 23 seasons in pro football, 6 in the CFL, Warren Moon threw for more than 70,000 yards and had some high times. One of the best was right here in the Rose Bowl. The 10, and now we go to John and Terry.
All right, Keith, thanks a lot. I don't think we're really surprised with how this first half has gone. Perhaps a little lower scoring than we'd expect, but both senior quarterbacks moving their teams.
They are mentioned, and they got that little bit of flat tire, but I think more importantly is the fact that Purdue got into the ball game and defensively settled down.
The Huskies will have the ball to start the second half of play, and I've often felt that the first possession of a second half in a close ball game could be a very significant possession. So we'll see what Washington can do here if they've been able to get the wrinkles out of their offense. It sort of went flat there at the closing moments of the first half. Purdue kicking off. Dortch hits it, and it's very high and not too long. Drifting back to the 7-yard line goes Rock Alexander. And he didn't get much out of that at all because the ball was up so high they decked him on the 15-yard line.
Take a look at Washington in that first half and Purdue special teams. Who was here with Stratton. Adrenaline flow, snapped it high, had a bad mistake. And Washington just turned it on. Tuiasa Sopo faked the condom, broke a tendency, and went in and scored. Pretty good first quarter for Washington and a good second quarter for Purdue.
It's Rich Alexis. Alexis, the freshman, into the ball game, who's got a very bad shoulder. And he was belted out of bounds, and he landed, I think, on that shoulder that he had hurt. So that one play may be all he gets today because he turned on the steam coming up the sideline.
Tuiasa Sopo on the option makes great decisions. Sees the defensive end, went with the pitch man, so he turns it up. But he knows his pitch man is still there. He locates him right now. Now he finds him, pitches it out. It is a behind the lateral. It's not a forward lateral. And there he goes. Alexis, as you mentioned, was banged up. He's had some problems, was a freshman All-American. But a great pickup and a great reading decision by Tui.
Ball is thrown very quickly to Reddick, and the pass is completed. It's gained about 5 yards for Washington, but back to Alexis. He was shaken up, and he is still shaken up, and we may not see him again today. He went for 50 yards on his first carry. There he is, and he went right down on that separated shoulder problem that he had.
Now, if he doesn't come back, all they have left is Braxton Clement and Willie Hurst. Willie Hurst is banged up.
Yeah, Willie's got a sore shoulder, too. broken. He had a broken shoulder, broken bone. Second down, call it six. Pitches outside, goes to Clemens. Getting to the corner, getting around the corner is the thing, and he may not have enough quickness to outrun Purdue's pursuers. Joe Odom, number 51 linebacker, over there to get him.
Rick Neuheisel's feeling at halftime was, hey, look, we've got the lead, and we've got the ball to start the second half. So let's get back and do what Washington does best. Let's put Tui on the corner. Let's work that a couple of times. We'll set up the pass to Stevens, and then we'll get this thing rolling. So you see his third down situation right here. He's 3 for 3. There he is again on third down and 5.
He throws and it's a bad pass.
Yes. Oh,
almost
sure was.
Almost intercepted by Gilbert Gardner. He had a lot of time, but that was a coverage downfield was very good by Purdue. And
he's still elusive. Even in a play like that, Tui Asisopo gets back. He'll milk as much time as he possibly can. He feels the pressure in the pocket. He tries to roll the opposite way and avoids one. Then tries to get it to Stevens, what they normally do on third down, but it was not available.
So it brings up fourth down and 5, and a 47-yard field goal try by John Anderson. He's got enough leg. He made it. 47 yards, and I mean he had a lot of air under it when it went over the goalpost. So the Huskies get 3 in their first possession to start the second half of play. And their lead goes back to 7, 17-10.
AT&T's wireless data technology can provide fast, easy access to over one.
Fielded at the 15-yard line by Benny Sutherland, found a hole up the middle of the field, gets to the outside. There's a penalty flag in his wake. And they finally bring him down inside the 40, down at the 35-yard line. And where's the flag?
Had a lot of penalties in the first half. 9 by Purdue, 4 by Washington.
Could be against the Huskies, you know that?
If it is, it's their 5th of the game.
Encroachment on the kickoff by the kicking team. That penalty is refused.
So big play with Vinnie Sutherland, and here's Purdue crank it away. Bobby Hauk, the special teams coach for the Huskies, not happy with that.
Great return. Watch this now. His eyes immediately go to the right side where he sees a hole and sprints that way. Very little false steps. Never. He's trying to get yardage everywhere he goes. When he outruns the kicker, he says, I better cut back to the inside. And that's the end of the run, but it was a great decision on his part.
Purdue ball, Washington 36-yard line, first down. Breeze turns and gives to Montrell Lowe. And Lowe will go down for perhaps a little loss on the play, but no more than the line of scrimmage.
Sheath, that man right there was the story of the first half. Montrell Lowe, just 5'8", 16 carries, 71 yards. Some of them spectacular. Watch this. His feet never touched the ground. He was the reason that Purdue was able to win the battle of time of possession by 5 minutes in the first half. Lowe with 71 exciting yards.
Call it second down and still about 10. Two wide at the top of the screen, two wide at the bottom. Not very many folks left in the middle. Breeze throws quickly and it's almost picked off. It almost went to the hands of Rock Alexander, who had nothing between him and the goal line except cool late afternoon's autumn air.
Well, I'll tell you what happened there, too. Washington went to a dime defense. They had 5 defensive backs in the game at one time. Rock Alexander's looking at Breeze the whole time and actually reads his eyes and goes that way. Tremendous step in by Rock Alexander, reading it all the way, and he almost had the pick.
Third down and 10. Out of the shotgun. Drew Brees throws to the sidelines, completes the pass. They've done that 4 times today. Vinnie Sutherland making the catch. They just go down the sideline and hide, and Huskies let him go.
We haven't seen Lowe since he had that helmet ripped off in that one tackle. Here you go right here as you look at Sutherland. He just runs a good out pattern. Runs him off. See Massey backed off. Couldn't make the turn or the cut as quickly.
So Lowe's back in there. He started to have. second half. Ball is down on the 24-yard line. And it's a first down on the catch by Sutherland. Reese keeps it. Wants to come back this way and does. And let's check in a moment with Todd Harris.
Well, Keith, the word on Montrell Lowe in that first half, as we saw, his face took a few licks. The helmet came off a couple times. They finally put a few stitches in his lip during the halftime. They are going to bring him back in. He will see more action throughout the day, so it's not going to stop him whatsoever. We're still checking on Rich Alexis, though. The doctor's still working on him.
All righty. That last pass was intended for Lowe, but he was well covered, and so Breeze just threw it away.
Go, Doug!
Just starting the second half, 17-10, Washington leading. Off of a 47-yard field goal by Anderson. Reese on second down and 10 throws high into the air to the end zone. Touchdown, Vinny Sutherland. Beautiful pass. Remember, Sutherland is only, I don't think, more than 5'9", for sure. And that ball was touched right into his hands perfectly. Rock Alexander and Greg Carruthers was there, and nothing they could do about it.
His second touchdown reception of the... Actually, of this season.
Look at that, where that pass was put.
You know, he's a 5'9 guy. He's not tall. We saw him get overthrown earlier, but we mentioned he's like Wayne Corbett. He is like that. He's a possession receiver, and he really knows how to separate from defenders.
33-yard line, first down for the Huskies now. I think Marcus Tuiasosopo knows that Purdue's about to take this game away from him. They don't get busy. Ball is thrown quickly and hard to Jeremy Stevens, and Stevens will pick up no more than 3 yards on the play. Wednesday, January 10, brand new Drew Gary show. Looks like it's the last call when the city tries to close down Drew's favorite watering hole. Brand new Drew Gary show at January 10, 9, 8 Central on ABC.
Saw Purdue's defense was a little bit shaky in that first quarter, and why not? I mean, they've got five freshmen playing on the defense for Purdue, but they really settled down. They've played quite nicely ever since.
Rich Alexis is back in the ball game. They strapped him up, and he wanted to come back, I guess, and the doctor said, well, you can go ahead. And here comes Tuiasosopo's option to Alexis. He turns inside, and they take him down just about the line of scrimmage by Landon Johnson. Here's Todd.
Well, Keith, as you and Tim pointed out, Rich Alexis has a history. What it is a subluxated right shoulder. We saw it happen the game we did up in Washington when they played UCLA. What they do basically is pop the shoulder back in, tape it, just try to support it and give some kind of stabilization. And Rich Alexis is not enough pain, and he said he wants to keep playing, so he is in.
Well, they need a speed. Third down and 6 now. Well, they say 5. Thing, it's third down. Pass is down the middle, caught by Jeremy Stevens for a first down for Washington, right on the midfield stripe.
We called for Stevens early in the ball game. We said Tuiasosopo likes to go to him often. Did not go to him that much in the first half, but here he is now. Stevens has 5 receptions for 50 yards. He's 6'7", but watch how he sits down in the open area. He just feels his way, can feel the defenders. He went to the seam, sat down, waited in the soft area for Tuiasosopo to find him, and there's your first down.
At midfield with 10 minutes exactly to play in the third quarter. Alexis and dropped his head and dove in there and picked up 2 yards.
Two great quarterbacks came into this ball game. Everybody knew they were the headliners. How are they doing head to head? Look at it. Both of them having pretty good games. 11 of 15 for Tui, 14 of 23 for Breeze. At one point, Breeze was 8 for 9, but you see the yardage differential right there in favor of Drew. But the minus 25 rushing yards, and a lot of that had to do with the 2 sacks, and of course, he was dropped twice behind the line of scrimmage on runs.
Braxton Clement is in at tailback now. And they've got double wide, bottom of the picture. Tua changing the play.
Play clock down to 5. He's got to get the snap.
3-step drop, throws quickly. Pass completed to Wilbur Hooks. And Hooks is right on the 40, and that ought to be a first down for Washington. It is.
I know those officials well.
This is Cunniff, the fullback. Pat Cunniff runs it inside the 25-yard line. It'll be Washington first down near the Purdue 23.
That right there is want to. That's desire. Kind of 6'1", 245 pounds. Watch your fullback ramble. And watch the strength that he has in his legs. Here's the hit. He turns, and look, keep those driving legs, and he moves forward for another 4 yards. Here's a guy that was playing with a dislocated shoulder. Just a strong running back.
First down, Tuiasosopo, play action, passes away to the end zone. No! Close. Todd Elstrom had it on his hands. Ball was met. They're holding Stevens. Guy had him by the sharp coattail and spun him around. Aiken Iadel gets the sack on Marcus Tuiasosopo.
Keith, you were right on top of that one, because in that situation, when they're second and long and third and long, we told you they like to go to Stevens. He's looking for him here, but watch this coverage. Turner's on him. Turner's got hands on him. Rides him hard. Stays in his hip pocket. Now comes up and jumps on his side, and there was no way that Tuiasosopo was going to throw into coverage down this deep in Purdue territory.
Ball is back on the 30-yard line, where it's third down and 17. Back to the 25, close to the original line of scrimmage. They might be within big old Lander, John Anderson's range again. He nailed a 47-yarder. Is he coming?
Yes, here he is. And that one he hit from 47 could have been good from 57.
Yep. So John, who is only a sophomore from Boynton Beach, Florida, he was 2-yarder. Snap was a little high, but he got all of it.
Wow.
Big leg, good. Huskies go back to the lead, 20-17, on a 42-yard field goal by John Anderson. Out on the goal line, here comes Clapton. Starting to cut outside, lost his footing, goes down 26-yard line.
Take a look at the AT&T action highlight, and you'll see that Vinny Sutherland's been the big play guy. Here he ran a post pattern, they hit him, then he runs it to the other side, he runs the flag, he goes out with it, and they hit him there. Two touchdowns tonight give him 13 for the season, or this afternoon. He has 13 for the season. That's a new Purdue record. Plus, Keith, he had that 51-yard kickoff return, which set up the touchdown.
Good player.
No turnovers in this ballgame.
Yep.
Well played.
Only really big mistake was that snap over the head of the corner. Ball down the middle. It's Sutherland and almost picked off. That's really good coverage by Omari Lowe. Lowe cutting in behind Sutherland, reading the ball just about right, and almost made the catch.
Pretty interesting. Sutherland thought he was open again, and Lowe had that closing speed. Right here, it looks like Sutherland's open, but watch Lowe close, and that's one of the guys they wanted to attack. Talking to the coaches and talking to Tim Hundley, the Jim Chaney, the offensive coordinator, says, hey, we're going to go at Lowe. We're going to take some shots at him. There's one of the shots. Lowe responded and broke it up nicely.
Second down and 10. Shotgun, breeze quickly, sideline, good, out of bounds. Out of bounds at the 31-yard line. Pick up 5 yards, Donald Winston. The attendance today, 94,392. 'Tis a fine gathering on a fine day.
And one of the greatest scenes in all of football.
Great menu. Third down and 5.
Breeze for the year, 58% on third down, the best in the nation.
Quickly, Sutherland, short of the first down. They didn't take him down on the first hit. He kept his feet, but they've stopped him 2 yards short of the first down. Akbar, involved in it.
Great stop by Washington.
We'll have to punt it away on 4th and 2. Low kick, tail dragger. Going to take a good roll for Purdue. Finally picked up by Butler back there, but he's immediately knocked at the 18-yard line. He kicked it away from Butler, and it was a low line drive tail dragger, and when he hit the ground, it took off like a rocket. It turns out to be a big kick of 53 yards. Merritt at deep back position. It's Alexis. Rich Alexis is in there, and he's coming right up the middle. No, it's Conniff, the fullback, coming right up the middle, the first man out of the two. Kouyasosopo throwing into the crowd. Completes it to Joe Collier. Tight end, who makes his first catch of the day. Big target. Joe 6'7", 260 from Spokane.
You know, what's amazing to me is Tuiasosopo so mobile, and you look at everything he's done, and he's only a two-year starter. Pac-10 Offensive Player of the Year, holds 11 Washington records, 8 career fourth-quarter comebacks. He's only been a two-year starter. Talked to Gil Brandt, the great scout in the NFL. He says, hey, listen, mobile quarterbacks are big right now in the NFL. This guy's a warrior. He can play.
Option. Oh, he got around the corner. Van Peck's favorite play, and got it to midfield and a first down for the Washington Huskies.
I think the only drawback would be on him, Keith, is he's a thick guy, and thick guys don't keep their speed as long as the more slender guys over the long haul. But right now, he's got terrific speed. He's got terrific strength. And look at the mobility he has, the fake, and then turn it up and look, get that extra yardage.
Money they're paying today, 5 years, you can go be a partner.
I'm with you.
First down from midfield for the Huskies. There's a push in the back. It's Terry Tharps. Terry Tharps coming around, and the Huskies are going to lose it. He's had a big push in the back.
I love these guys doing a great job.
What are your impressions? Evaluate number 11 for me.
Oh, he's a great player. You know, he's a playmaker. He doesn't have the greatest arm. He doesn't have the greatest size, but he makes plays and he wins, and that's what a quarterback's supposed to do.
Great to see you, Warren.
Thanks a lot. Happy New Year.
What a good player he was. What a good guy he is. The ball is at the 44-yard line now as they get it across. And it'll be third down and about 5.
Design play. Looked like it was a broken play, but it was designed for Marcus Tuiasosopo to take that thing off tackle behind two big blockers. It'll bring up third down and long. And again, we tell you, that's where they normally look for Stevens.
At the lunch yesterday, I saw little Bob Schlorette. I'll tell you what, that one-eyed quarterback, back-to-back Rose Bowl MVPs, that's almost unheard of, but Bobby was. Third down and 5. In a hurry. Can't do it. You know what, he lost his footing. He got skating around out there on all that paint Tim was talking about. You let it dry too much. Because it is really slick when you run onto that rose, and he lost his footing.
Well, I'll tell you something else, too. They are not letting Jeremy Stevens loose. They had two guys on him. He's up here at the top of your screen, 14, trying to release. Marcus never had any time. They pinched him hard, so he decided to run it, which was a wise thing to do. Still couldn't get free.
Landon Johnson is the one that messed up that play for Washington. The new outside guy on defense. Ryan Fleming punting. Pops it up in the air high. Sutherland gets away from it, takes a bounce, and the bounces, and it's going to roll dead at the Purdue 4-yard line. Well done, Mr. Fleming. Ruby's coming aboard now. Not much real estate at his back.
You look at this, he's set almost every record you can imagine. These are pretty good numbers when you look at this. You go all the way down to the bottom to the total offense down there. What do we say that was? That's about 7 miles worth of total offense.
From the 4. Be careful, country. Hands it off. Montrell Lowe skating around. We'll get about a yard on the carry before Anthony Kelly puts him away. Isn't Anthony Kelly the one that's going off to South Africa for advanced studies?
Yes, he is.
He's excited about that. He was a young man that didn't care much about all the classwork, but along the way and getting to where he is, some teacher lit his candle and he is absorbed with it. Running it low. Ankle tackle at the 9-yard line. They'll give his progress to the 10. And again, it's Anthony Kelly. Here's Todd with more on this interesting young man.
Well, Keith, he's just an absolute delight of a kid. He'll take a leave following the game. He heads to South Africa on the 5th. He'll be back in March. Now, he got the Mary Gates Scholarship. If the name sounds familiar, it's Bill Gates' mother. She was a regent at the University of Washington. He's the first University of Washington athlete to get it. And get this, he was a partial qualifier out of high school. Rick Neuheisel says South Africa will never be the same.
Give a kid a chance, though. He can succeed.
That's right. Third down and 4. Out of the shotgun, Brees quickly to the sidelines, and they're short of the first down. I think
it's going to be close.
It's close. That was John Standiford, who hasn't seen the ball all that much today. They're going to measure. Rock Alexander may have been a tad late getting it.
I think he got a pretty good mark. You watch this, and the ball's delivered on time, but he doesn't have time to turn because they close on him quickly. He's looking at that first down marker, and he's trying to get there, but a terrific hit by Alexander, who, by the way, is playing a great game. Came in as the dimebacker. Now he was playing so well, they're playing him more and more in the base defense.
He's another one of those precocious freshmen.
Please back up over here.
You got it?
Got a good spot, and I still don't think he made it.
It is short.
Just short. It'll take some gizzard to go for it down there.
No, it's not a good call, Keith. Not in a close ball game like this with so much time left and these being two fourth quarter teams.
Look, Joe's been played at Montana State. And he's seen all the snowfalls along the whole Rocky Mountain range and evolved this offense. But he isn't going to gamble here.
It would take gizzard to go for it, but if he doesn't make it, they'll rip that gizzard out.
I don't think he's going to.
No, no way.
If it was minute 5 to play in the game instead of a minute 5 to play in the third quarter, that might be different.
Sure.
Scott Kurse standing right back around his goal line. No pressure. Good kick to midfield. Ball caught. No fair catch and a penalty flag.
They were inside the halo again. That's the second time today they've been called inside that halo, and they're not giving him that 2 yards they have to give him.
Might have a face mask, too. Cody Pickett warming up on the sidelines because Marcus Tuiasosopo ran down the tunnel a moment ago.
Non-contact kick catching interference by the kicking team. 5 yards from the spot.
That's 10 run. There's a look at Keith Gilbertson.
So here's Cody Pickett in the hot box now for the first time in the Rose Bowl. Dropped. The ball is dropped by Rich Alexis. So you got two freshmen handling the ball there, and they don't do a very good job of it.
Well, you mentioned that he's coming into a tight fit situation. He hasn't done it very often. As a matter of fact, Tuiasosopo has taken almost every snap in his career, all but 35 in 2 years. So the timing's a little bit off, although it looked like the handoff was there and probably should have been taken properly by Alexis.
Pickett barely shows up in the season review, to tell you the truth. Here's Cody's first pass. It's a beauty right on his hands and out of bounds at the 40-yard line. Todd Elstrom made the catch. Young fella from Puyallup. Here's the latest from Todd.
Well, here's the word from the trainer. I just talked and they took him in. It's a right AC sprain of, unfortunately, his throwing arm. They said it's not too bad, but they want to take a picture just to make sure they think he'll be back.
Well, Pickett's biggest role so far was against Washington State. He came in and engineered a 7-play, 27-yard drive for a touchdown.
Willie Hurst is the tailback right now. So he's thrown once. He's going to throw twice. Passes away, and it's caught. but it's going to be short of a first down. On third down and six, he had to come back for the ball, Justin Robbins, and he's going to be a yard short of the first down.
Now, Washington will take a good look at this, because this is close enough to go for.
They're even better.
Pretty good. He was throwing okay on the sidelines. He may just quarterback sneak it.
He might. So it's fourth down, and the first time in the ball game we've had a play come up with this structure. It goes to Rich Alexis, the tailback, and he went through there like an 18-wheeler going downhill and got the first down.
And Pat Conniff was out in front of him leading the way.
So Tuia Sisopo becomes a very dramatic persona here for a moment as he comes back in after having been examined, pictured, and strapped up.
I think this is the injury right here. He comes down hard on that right shoulder. Watch when he lands. He breaks away from the tackle and then slams down on the right shoulder, and he immediately reaches up there.
So they've got their first down. And he hands the ball away to Alexis again. He just goes straight ahead. And grabbing a hold of him as he goes by is number 42, Brent Butts. So the Washington offensive front, now remember, a bunch, there are five 300-plus pounders up there, and they can pound on you. We are in the fourth quarter.
Yeah, you look at the rushing of Washington, interesting. They led the Pac-10 212 rushing yards a game, despite the fact the Huskies didn't have a single runner in the top 10 individually most of the year.
Doesn't matter.
By committee.
On you, boy.
By committee.
Yep. Second down and eight. They're inside and beaten again. And they're going to take it down to about the 25-yard line.
You know what they're doing here. They're not only pounding that ball now. They're not only getting physical and taking over this thing, but they're melting the clock and shortening the game. We're down under 14 minutes now.
Leading 20 to 17. Remember, the Big Ten has won seven of the last eight of these Rose Bowl games, and they've got a pretty good string going again.
Both of these clubs are fourth quarter clubs.
Third down, three, option, and Tuia Sisopo turns inside, and leg strength may have got him the first down. Gilbert Gardner had a hold of him. He's 216 pounds. Tuia Sisopo weighs at least 220.
Purdue wants a measure. Nope, they're not going to get one. It's a first down. And Tui again, he cut back up rather than trying to take it outside and play with the tackler, just forced him to follow him into that gap. And he lunged forward and got the first. Now the strategy really does become keep away. Keep Drew Brees on the sidelines as much as you possibly can.
Ball is on the 23, just inside the 23, so it goes in the books as the 22. Tuia Sisopo throws to the sidelines, complete to Todd Elstrom. And Elstrom is rolled out of bounds by Woodyard, and he is short of the first down. This is Rich Alexis, and he's passed the 10 down to the 8. Aiken Adele brings it down. Well, oh, Marquise, young and limber, he can win.
Little mix-up on the play. The timing was off, and Tuia Sisopo and Alexis bumped into each other. Right now, that offensive line is pounding. Watch this. Here's the collision. Throws him off, but look at the cutback. Stevens kind of standing around, not getting a block to help him back on the cutoff. But right now, Silver, Sprays, Ben, Ward, and Call are dominating that line of scrimmage.
It is first down, goal to go from the Purdue 8-yard line with Braxton Clemen at tailback.
Play clocks at one.
Just got it off. Air ball to the corner. Touchdown. Todd Elstrom out jumped the defender for the sixth. They picked on the 5'7 quarterback, and it paid off. Elstrom, 6'3. Clopton, 5'7. Guess who wins that jump ball?
Well, you're right. The coaches say that Clopton's a pit bull, but he's a short one. And you take a 6'3 guy, and Tuia Sisopo really knows how to put the ball high. He does it with Stevens, and here he does it with Elstrom. It says, go up and get it. It's a jump ball. And if a 6'3 guy can't outjump a 5'7 guy, shame on him.
And the extra point try now by John Anderson. And it's good. So it's a 27-17 ball game now as Marcus Tuiasosopo takes a short high kick. It is fielded well up the field, and it is Pete Lockheed, and he'll get up to about the 28-yard line. Now the FedEx game summary.
Well, you see where the score is right now, and the rushing belongs to Washington. Let me say this. The Rose Bowl winner has won the rushing battle in 24 of the last 27 games. And with that ability to run the football coming into this half, Washington 14 minutes, Purdue only 4 in time of possession, as you look at the rest of those numbers.
And now, Mr. Breeze, your stage. Ball is on the 28-yard line very quickly. Outside it goes to Donald Winston. Very simple little stand-up play, but it works for pretty good yardage. Picked up about 8. Today's aerial coverage provided by AT&T. And there's the sun sliding gently into the Pacific.
These have been 5 of the most beautiful days I've ever seen in Southern California.
Don't tell anybody.
Clear as a bell. You can have all those Easterners moving out here. Midwestern.
Question after this play. Under center, turns, penalty flag goes down, ball is handed off. Play stops just about the line of scrimmage. How much are you allowed to curl your offensive line?
Well, we've got Dave Perry up here. That's something that they cannot get off that offensive line. They have to be aligned with the other lineman. It can't be a yard off that line. They can't be 2 feet off that line. They've got to have a hand on that line of scrimmage, do they not? All right, so the helmet must be on the imaginary line. See, they can't cheat at all. And that's something Rick Neuheisel was talking to the officials about before the ball game to watch for.
There have been a couple of times it looked like a semicircle.
Well, that's illegal. They won't always call it, but Rick Neuheisel was trying to alert them to it.
They picked up the first down.
There's your offensive line. You can see their helmet's supposed to be on that line of scrimmage.
Breeze down there, and it is incomplete. He had it on the hands of his receiver, Standiford, but John was in some traffic and couldn't reel it in. Ben Madavi was the man covering on the play for the Huskies, and now Drew Breeze is going to be looking at 2nd down and 10.
This ball was thrown so well right a little bit behind right it, but I mean right where only his guy, John Standiford, could get it. That ball has to be caught.
The thing that amazes me about him in traffic like that, with the sky falling on him, he's able to put touch. Had 3 wide outs at the top, go back the other way. The pass was completed, and it's a big gain for Purdue as Cedric Brown came out of the backfield. They had 3 wide receivers up the top of the picture to the left, came back to the right to the fullback, and got a big play out of it.
Brown's one of those guys. He plays mostly on the 3rd down game.
Lowe took a wicked hit from Greg Carruthers, and he's still down. Carruthers covers the ball. I'm not sure that Greg had a piece of the hit or not. But it was a slashing blow as they're trying to get it in the end zone and shorten that 10-point lead. It is Carruthers that hit him. And Tuiasosopo options down to Willie Hurst. And Hurst got around the corner. Both had the speed to turn that corner on the option, and Willie just did it there. It's 1st down, move the chain. The time remaining, 10 minutes and 46 seconds in the ball game. Washington is leading 20.
Look at the 2nd half. Washington 14-08 to just 5-06
for this snap. And it's Hurst. Oh, Willie's motor's running. He's inside the 40-yard line, down to the 38. Again, I say to you, you've got 5 300-plus pounders along the offensive front, and they've been beating on them all day long, and it's getting now into the middle of the 4th quarter.
And how many times, Keith, have you heard out here about the Pac-10 being a wine and cheese conference, being soft, especially last year? I don't think so anymore, especially Washington. This is a very strong, physical football team.
First down at the Purdue 38-yard line. Cunniff gets a carry, And the big fullback from Woodinville is inside the 35. Second down and six for the Washington Huskies on the Purdue 34-yard line. Run it with Hurst. Willie turns. He's good at that. And he swings around against Arizona up in Seattle when Washington played him. He made one of those turns and kept his feet. One of the great plays of the season.
Watch this. Look at the balance. Look at the turn. Look at the low center of gravity he has. That's the move he just tried to put on there. But that one is incredible. How he kept his balance, I don't know. That's a great athletic move. And watch. He does it here again. A little spin. Not the same kind of pirouette, but he tried to spin his way off.
Wouldn't let him go. It's on the 27 of Purdue now. First down, Washington. Riyasa circles, missed. Way back behind the line of scrimmage. Gets his pass away. It is complete to Collier. Collier now this season, including the bowl game, has caught three passes.
Action, play action. He rolls the opposite way. He's outside. He could have run or passed here. Boy, he is just such a dangerous player.
I think you're beginning to see now why I call him the Warrior. Boy, he's a tough guy.
Well, you heard Warren Moon say he's not the best passer around, he's not the best runner, but definitely the most dangerous, and he's got Purdue right now guessing.
Belly series almost there as Pat Connick goes inside the 10-yard line and down to about the 8 before he's finally brought down. He's a little bit short, substituting as they've been able to do. They keep pounding it. This is Hurst. Touchdown. Willie Hurst right up the pipe.
Keith, that's like using a workhorse and a thoroughbred. Conniff ran the ball the last time. He's the big pounder at 245 pounds. Then they come back with Willie Hurst, who's only 5'10 and slight of build, but is explosive as a runner through a hole. Watch Conniff lead him up and watch Hurst just explode with speed through the hole. Wide open hole. There's the block by Conniff. Not a big one, but just enough to throw him out of rhythm and keep him off Hurst.
Anderson for the point. Contact along the line of scrimmage. The kick is up and the kick is good. I think that'll be flagged off, and unless one of the Huskies was moving before the snap. Anderson kicks off. Skittering thing. It's caught on by the up man again. That's the second time that Lockheed has made the reception up around the 30-yard line.
Keith, let's go back to the Dell Game Solutions, and you can see the total play advantage. Let me break this down very simply for you. When Purdue has more plays than the opponent, they normally win. And when they don't, they've lost. Today, they've had six less plays, but here in the second half, Washington has run 37 plays to just 15 for Purdue.
Let me say to you folks, this thing, it ain't over. Like Yogi warned you, it ain't over till it's over. There's 7 minutes and 17 seconds. And if anybody can get it done in a hurry, this is the guy right here. And Reese throws complete to A.T. Simpson, and he's right on the first down marker. As we go along in the game, I would like to say that the gentlemen from the Atlantic Coast Conference have done a fine job officiating this ball game. The referee, Jack Childress, and his crew, are an outstanding guy. Reese looking to go big. Now gets a little bit of heat. Finally chased out of the pocket. He's got all day, and he has to throw. And they say no. Never had control of it. Sutherland went out of bounds with the ball wiggling around in his hand.
Saw some of Drew Brees' escapability there, though. He hits that internal feel. He knows when people are coming. He's got an instinct to know. And he got outside the pocket and rolled. But here's what you're talking about, not having possession. See him bobbling the ball as he goes out of bounds.
He went to his left and still really put something on it, put some heat on the ball. He's not a gimme, I'll tell you. He's 6'1", 220. You're not going to get him for nothing. Second down and 10. Reese throws to the sidelines, and the pass is caught. And again, it's just short of the first down marker.
Told you about the ability of both of these teams to be strong in the fourth quarter. Well, Purdue had to come from behind. And here's, I know that this really impressed you. I mean, these are some of their comebacks.
That's just remarkable.
These are some of the comebacks they had. And look how they won late.
Yeah, but look who they're playing.
I know it.
I mean,
how about the October they had?
Oh, wow. That really is impressive.
But they can come from behind, and it's because, like you said, Drew Brees just has a gun.
Third down and one. Throwing to the first down. It's not good. Bounced off the shoulders of Cedric Brown.
I'm not sure he would have made it had he made the catch, but, you know, Drew Brees is going to lead a comeback. He's got to get some help. They've had a lot of drop balls in this ballgame.
Fourth and one, and they're going. There's no question about this. Defending here is Omari Lowe and Jamon Willis.
That ball still has to be caught.
So here's a fourth and one call.
This is the ball game.
At the 41. 6:47 to play. This baby is wrapped in the best tinsel. It's a run. It's good for the first down. And he isn't through yet. He scores. Touchdown, Purdue. Cedric Brown refused to give up on the sideline, just kept pumping, and the Huskies could never get him out of bounds.
And you know who threw a key block? Drew Brees. It wasn't a great block, and it wasn't a block that would knock a guy off his feet. But he was out there scrambling just enough to keep him off his running back. Now watch, here's the handoff. Keep an eye on 15 come around and try to help Brown out. Now watch, Drew Brees, 15, diving over right here, the running back, trying to readjust and getting just enough to get him off his feet and let Brown come around the corner. I'm not sure he didn't step on the line.
No, I don't think he did. No, I think he was in all the way. The kick is in the middle of the uprights and good. Like I said, Yogi's right. Yogi's always been right. Clemens opens a tailback for this possession, and now the Purdue folks on the other end of the Rose Bowl have taken heart. They're making all the noise they can make. Got to travel a long way. A little option here goes to Clemens. He's getting to the corner, and he can't turn the corner. Purdue strung that one out as far as they could run it. Number 9, Schweigert, was over there along with Sean Phillips.
Schweigert, the safety, made the tackle with Phillips, and Turner, the other safety, was in Tui Asisopo's face and almost caused a bad handoff. Watch how quickly he gets there. He comes on a safety blitz, number 8. He was up at the line of scrimmage and got to Tui Asisopo in a hurry. But Tui read it, pitched it, and he still got positive yardage.
Yeah, Ralph Turner, wasn't he? He was a quarterback, option quarterback in college, in high school before he came to college. Second down and the long 5. Hand it off, run it up to about the 25-yard line. They're going to need another 3 yards after that carry.
Talk about running the football. It's been pretty lopsided this half. Washington had its way for most of it. Here's a good indication of it.
Well, they just got a wake-up call. It's only a 10-point difference right now.
Still, you get 179 rushing yards in one half. That's moving the football.
Yeah, but they got to go now and get a long 3 on third down. Otherwise, Purdue's going to get good field position. Tui Asisopo kept it. Pitches it back.
Whoa.
And Purdue's got the ball. Bad decision.
He doesn't make many of them, Keith, but that definitely was. He was trying to do too much. He felt he was going to be tackled. He felt his pitch man was still with him all the way downfield and pitched it, and it couldn't be handled.
So it is Ashante Woodyard who comes up with the loose football, and the Boilermakers have a new life.
Boy, when this works, you say, what a great athlete this guy is to have the presence to know his pitch man's still there. But in this instance, when you're just trying to get out of the ball game, boy, that is a bad decision. It really could have been caught, but the bottom line is it wasn't. And it's a costly turnover and puts Purdue right back into this ball game.
Well, you've got your first down. You've got the middle of the field. You've got at least 4 more snaps to use up another 2 minutes.
Don't need to pitch it at that point.
Right. And Purdue's moving. Left tackle dancing. Matt Light had gone to the prom right there, and it was very, you can't miss Matt. He's an All-American tackle, and he's at 304 out of Greenville, Ohio.
Bolt start. And by absolutely the offense, 5 yards. It's still first down.
Charming guy. We talked to him quite some time the other day, and he
He was a wrestler in high school and probably is going to do a lot of playing on Sunday. First down and 15.
Pretty great numbers.
Ball's thrown right to the sidelines. That play's worked all day long. John Standiford this time.
Very wisely, he gets out of bounds, stops the clock. 5:26 to play.
Ball is put inside the 44-yard line for a second down and three. Johnson.
It also stops the clock. He doesn't have to get out of bounds. 5:19 on the clock. First down, they move the chains. The clock stops. Watch this. This is a great read by Tui Asisopo. He read the defense. He saw they were in a two deep zone coverage. He found his man on the post.
Pumps it, goes for the corner. No. Incomplete. Pass again intended for Vinny Sutherland, but he turned inside, lost his footing. Or turned outside and lost his footing in the duel with Massey.
Still, the incompletion stops the clock.
Boy, they get a lot of plays, don't they?
They sure do.
Offensive coordinator's Jim Cheney, and he ought to go on the road. He's a funny guy.
I said, how difficult is your offense to learn? He says, if a rock had lips, he can tell you how it plays.
Reese quickly again over the middle. The ball goes almost intercepted. Oh, that wasn't a very good decision either.
Look
you
who it is.
Almost, yeah, Larry Triplett.
They were in a zone blitz. That means Triplett dumps out of there. Breeze wasn't expecting to see Big Triplett, the nose tackle, drop out of there. Here he is right here. Watch, he's going to come back like this. You know, Triplett's 295 pounds. Watch him move. Contact, drop back, almost had the interception. Still chasing it.
Well, they've doubled Larry most of the day.
They sure have. First team All-American. He'll be playing on Sundays. Quality player.
Third down and 10. And we may go soon, because we're going to think about it after this game's over. Who's pass? He is over the head of the receiver. Incomplete. They're looking at fourth and 10. Omari Lowe defending against Vinny Sutherland. Lowe's a little bit bigger, 205 and 6 feet.
I'd go for the field goal here, Keith. You need 10 points. It's 10 yards for a first. The percentages aren't in your favor. Get out there, get the field goal, come back and get the touchdown later.
Hell, Dortch is out there. I'll tell you what, this fella wearing that black hat there, pretty crafty. He knows what he's doing.
It's all down to game management now, time management.
Ben Smith holding, John Sheldon snapping. 6 foot, 6 inch place kicker. Out of leg. And no good. He missed it.
Wow.
Oh, my. The ebb and flow of the last few minutes of this football game has been incredible.
Can't imagine the feeling. Your heart must sink. When you get everything you can into this thing and you're watching it and it's sailing left, left, and you're saying, just hang on, and it goes left by about 2 yards, and then watch Rick Neuheisel on the other side. Yes, sir. It's going left. He's a golfer. He knows how those things drift.
And so the Huskies hold the Boilermakers to the sidelines. The offense pondering what might have been. The defense on the field, bone tired, but fighting till their last gasp. And here's Washington's offense. First down from number 25. Time remaining now is 4:54, and this is Rich Alexis running for a first down over the 35 to the 36-yard line. The freshman from Florida may have a sore shoulder, but I'll tell you what, he's playing tough. Coming up right after we get through here will be the Tostitos Fiesta Bowl as Oregon State and Notre Dame have at it. In another of the Bowl Championship Series, first time those two teams have ever met. Oregon State lost only one time. That was up in Seattle, and they watched a field goal stay wide right by about 3 feet. That would have forced a tie in that game.
Most speed the Irish have seen all year.
Oh, yeah. And here is Alexis.
Texas bouncing off the pile and coming to the outside and getting to the 40-yard line. He's got 4 yards on the play where he probably should have been dropped for a loss.
After Tui Asisopo turned the ball over in the last offensive position of the possession, Rick Neuheisel, I'm sure, got that offense together and said, hey, look, guys, be smart. Here's the biggest game of your lives. All you have to do now is hold on to the football, and we'll get out of here with a win. Very, probably unusual. It's going to be rare if you see Tui Asisopo throw a pass the rest of the way.
Alexis has 9 carries since he got going in the second half for 77 yards.
He's dipping that shoulder and going strong at him, too.
Second down and 6. This time there's only a yard. Here's Todd.
Well, Keith, Coach Rick Neuheisel does not eat before games, even when it's an evening game. I don't know if it goes back to when he was a player here. He came to the Rose Bowl sick as a dog with food poisoning. He walked down the tunnel. He came separate from the team. His dad said, what's wrong? He said, Dad, I'm sick. I got food poisoning. His dad said, so what? This is the biggest game of your life. Get in there. Rick said he went into the field, never felt sick again.
We've got 3 minutes and 27 seconds to play in the football game. Washington fighting to hold on at 34-24.
We can expect Amy. In coming months.
His direct himself.
Huskies can get 2 more first downs. They can win this football game. If they have to give it up right here, Purdue is still in it. Willie Hurst is the tailback. Ball is handed off to the fullback, Pat Conniff. And Conniff bangs his way to the 45, and he is 1 yard short of the first down.
Tui Asisopo wants to go for the first. I think I'd punt it away, but he's got Rick Neuheisel's attention.
I don't think I would.
I would definitely not, but Tui Asisopo says he wants to go for it. Rick Neuheisel's leaving him on the field.
I don't see a punter out there.
Nope. He had called the punting team up, and Tui Asisopo looked to the side and said, we've got to go for it, and Rick told those guys to back off.
He's got 6 seconds left on the play clock, so what they're going to do is spend the timeout or take the penalty. They're going to take the timeout and talk about it. And I know that there's a lot of Husky faithful wringing their hands and shouting and pleading and begging to punt it.
Well, the punting team's coming back up to Neuheisel.
At least make them go the long way. But with the presence of Drew Brees, you know, a long field doesn't mean that much. And here comes Ryan Fleming, I think.
Oh, I still haven't seen him. Jeremy Stevens comes in. He's usually your. Yep.
Fiesta Bowl with Oregon State and Notre Dame. They're coming up right after we get through. And remember that it was Washington that inflicted the only loss on the Oregon State Beavers up in Seattle. That's the field goal try. It was wide right. With the Huskies leading 33-30, that's the only game the Beavers lost this year. Notre Dame had a remarkable error-free season for them. So few turnovers. Very, very efficient football team.
About 5 yards right of an undefeated season.
Yep. I think that's going to be a terrific football game.
How about this club right here beat Miami? And Miami's down there saying, hey, look, we beat Florida State. We ought to be number one. But this club right here at 10-1, having beaten Miami's got a claim to something.
All right, it's 4th and 1, and here comes a big old, I mean, this is showing some grit, folks. He keeps it. He's got it. He's got a first down at midfield, and this time he didn't pitch it. And that ought to be your ball game. Well, I'll tell you what, I remember a long time ago, maybe 1967 at the Gator Bowl down in Jacksonville when Joe Paterno went on a play similar to that in the middle of the field. Florida State came back and beat him. Ron Sellers and that bunch.
Tell you this about Marcus Tui Asisopo. He is talented, he is exciting, and sometimes erratic. But what a big play player.
So on first down at midfield and the clock running now at 2:10, that may very well have been the ball game. If the Huskies don't turn it over, that play is good for about 3 yards. And I want to do some credits here. Executive producer of ABC Sports is Howard Katz. Executive producer college football, John Filippelli. Director of production, Bob Toms. Coordinating producer, Bob Goodrich. The guys I've worked with all season, and I think they're wonderful. Producer Mark Loomis, Patrick McManus is our director, John Zippe, our technical director, associate producer Derek Mobley, associate director is Jeff Kibler, technical manager Dennis Zabo, production manager Joe Alvarado, our assistants to the producer Jason Trevico, Tom Wicks, statistician Mark Amento, Kelly Hayes, Mark and Kelly, Kelly our spotter, and Mark and Kelly having just come back from the NFL playoffs, computer stats Brian Shiroto and Freddie Amos, and our stage manager Dave Henner. I've been doing college football for 48 seasons, and I don't know that I've ever enjoyed one more than this year.
I'll tell you this, partner, it's been fun for me too, and happy new year to you, and thanks for everything this season.
Timmy Brandt and Todd Harris pleasantly working the sidelines today. No snow, no ice, and no heat. And a good job.
Purdue takes that timeout, Keith, and they've got one remaining. But as you mentioned, it is a high hill to climb now.
For Joe Taylor's staff, Ken Green, Mark Hagan, Greg Olson, Scott Downing, Brock Speck, Jim Cheney, we mentioned, Danny Hope, Kevin Sumlin, Gary Emanuel. Brought an entertaining, interesting football team to the Rose Bowl. Had a good time. And this is Willie Hurst running to the outside. And a big ball game for Willie, coming home to perform. And he's picked up another first down for Washington. And for the Washington Huskies, Rick Neuheisel's staff, Keith Gilbertson and Tim Hundley, Chuck Heater, Steve Axman, Brent Myers, Randy Hart, Wayne Moses, Bobby Hawk, and Tom Williams, another outstanding coaching job. Going to go 11-1. This is a team winning this ball game today that will finish the season 11-1, and they beat the Miami Hurricanes. So we could have a split championship. I mean, the Associated Press is not committed to the BCS poll. The coaches poll is. And this is Willie Hurst bouncing around again and picking up a couple of yards.
Minute and a half left, and of course they're still running as hard as they possibly can, melting that clock and getting out of here with their Rose Bowl championship. Very, very disappointing game for Purdue, but if you look at the quarterback comparison, and certainly they were the guys that everybody was talking to coming in or talking about coming into this ball game. Terrific game by both of these quarterbacks. You see the minus 25 down here, though. Two sacks. He was tackled two other times for big losses when he was trying to scramble. Both of them quality guys that'll be playing on Sunday. Matter of fact, Gil Brandt, Keith, told me that he thinks Drew Brees is the same as Peyton Manning, only 3 inches shorter.
Well, Brees and Manning spent some time together. I guess Peyton, in some sense, has become sort of a mentor for a young Brees. Clock ticking along now, 35 seconds, and now it's a matter of just running it out. And the flash bulbs are popping, and Rick Neuheisel has been drenched. And he was trying to avoid it, but he had no chance. They had him right in their sights and nailed him.
Yeah, but you know, that bath there is not nearly as hard to take as those ones when it is frigid and snowing like it was last night down in Louisiana.
And you know what? There's a guy back in Indiana, Bart Burrell, who's watching tonight, had a good football game, and he's got his health back, and he's one of the happiest guys in the world. We'll return with the new Ford Escape post-game show after this message. 34-24 Washington.
Coach, it's been a long season for you. I know this means a lot to you and your Huskies, but let's talk about CW number 25. You made a promise to him and you delivered today.
Well, Curtis, I know you're sitting up there, partner. This one's for you, baby.
The Washington Huskies, the 2001 Rose Bowl champions. Thanks, Coach.
Thanks very much. It's an honor. The entire state of Washington is honored. We're back where we belong, back in Pasadena.
That's it, Keith. Back up to you.
ABC Sports Online, ESPN.com, keyword ABC College Football. This is a presentation of ABC Sports.